The longer I live, the more the metal of dear old Nana impresses me. Those years should have seen her well taken care of, mint tea and knitwork by the fire. Instead, she was on her feet, scurrying about here and there, task after task, night after night, till the day the woman died, may she sleep soundly. It wasn't fair losing Mom and Dad like we did. It wasn't fair to any of us. Nana never complained, never wavered. I take strength from her example, even now.
Ha ha ha!
If I didn't care for adventurers as a child, by my 16th summer, I came to resent them. Even when doing something noble, they were so smug and self-important. Rarely paid much mind to the humble folk who spent our days tidying their rooms and fluffing their pillows. Worse still, none of them had managed to vanquish the shadow. Not in all those years. What good's the hero if he can't slay the dragon?
Huh?
There it was. Isla had been training with the adventurers. For a good while, too, judging by the grace of her draw. Seems a petty thing in hindsight, but in that moment, her secret struck me as a personal betrayal. There was a flurry of emotions marching into that clearing, burned and bitter, a pot of stew boiling over.
Ah. Thank you. Thank you. Sure.
Huh.